Man-made nuclear radiation evokes both fascination and fear. The nuclear disasters at Chernobyl and Fukushima are good examples of this. While the meltdown at the Chernobyl power plant caused thousands of nearby residents to flee their homes in 1986, tourists now flock to the area after watching the HBO series Chernobyl 33 years later. 8 years after a large earthquake and tsunami caused a nuclear meltdown at the Fukushima Daiichi plant, some Fukushima evacuees face an uneasy homecoming, marked by mistrust of government officials and worry whenever their dosimeters detect spikes in radiation. The Fukushima nuclear disaster has also been the subject of several films, including the documentaries Nuclear Nation and Fukushima, A Nuclear Story, and a new film is in the works called Fukushima 50. Now, another place made radioactive by man has attracted media attention. A Newsweek article recently reported that some of the Marshall Islands have radiation levels higher than Fukushima and Chernobyl, according to scientists. The Marshall Islands in the Pacific Ocean might seem like a tropical paradise, but it's far from pristine. Some of the northern Marshall Islands were part of the Pacific Proving Grounds, and the United States conducted 67 nuclear weapons tests there from 1946 to 1958. And Niuetoc Atoll in the Marshall Islands was the testing site of one of the world's first hydrogen bombs in 1952, and the 15-megaton Castle Bravo hydrogen bomb test occurred on Bikini Atoll in 1954. The Castle Bravo test resulted in the evacuation of 167 Bikini Islanders, who thought their evacuation was temporary, and a little over 200 Marshallese were exposed to radioactive fallout in nearby atolls. The U.S. government has spent millions of dollars to compensate those displaced and injured by the nuclear testing. It's also attempted to clean up the radioactive waste left behind by these nuclear tests, but a study recently published in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Science, or PNAS, shows the U.S. government still has a lot more work to do. For this study, Columbia University researchers measured the external gamma radiation found in 9 islands in 4 atolls of the northern Marshall Islands affected by nuclear weapons testing. They took measurements in several islands in the Bikini and Niuetoc atolls because these atolls were used as ground zero for tests. They also checked gamma radiation levels in islands in Rongelap and Utrecht atolls because they were affected by radioactive fallout from the largest nuclear test the United States has ever conducted, the Bravo test held March 1, 1954. Most of the measurements were taken in 2015, but additional measurements were made in trips to these areas in 2017 and 2018. The results are given in millirems per year, which is a measurement of the dose equivalent. The U.S. Nuclear Regulatory Commission, or USNRC, states that the dose equivalent or effective dose combines the amount of radiation absorbed and the medical effects of that type of radiation. The USNRC adds that units for dose equivalent are the Rontgen equivalent man and sievert, and biological dose equivalents are commonly measured in 1/1000th of a rem, known as a millirem or mrem. The researchers found that external gamma radiation was highest on Bikini Island and Bikini Atoll, and Nain Island and Rongelap Atoll. They took a total of 185 measurements on Bikini Island. In 2015, the lowest and highest external gamma radiation measurements on Bikini Island were 11 millirems a year and 648 millirems a year, and these values did not change after additional measurements were taken in 2017 and 2018. However, the mean for the full dataset increased significantly, rising from 184 millirems a year to 191 millirems a year. On Nain Island, they only took 18 measurements. The researchers reported that measured values ranged from 34 to 543 millirems a year, or 0.34 to 5.43 millisieverts a year. They added that Nain has the highest average external gamma radiation levels of all islands we visited during 3 trips to the northern Marshall Islands, 2015, 2017, and 2018. However, they also noted that large sections of the island were not measured, causing some uncertainty in the interpolation to those areas. To get an idea of just how much radiation is still in the Marshall Islands, we'll compare it to radiation from a common radiation source. According to the CDC, the typical dose from a chest X-ray is 0.01 rems, or 10 millirems. This means that if you were to visit Bikini Island, you'd receive about as much radiation as you'd get from one chest X-ray on the low end to about 64 chest X-rays on the high end. The mean or average amount of radiation you'd receive would be equivalent to about 18 to 19 chest x-rays. On Nain Island, you'd receive radiation that's equivalent to about 3 to 54 chest x-rays. The high-end figure of 648 millirems a year of gamma radiation on Bikini Island is slightly higher than the average dose of radiation people living in the US are exposed to each year, which the CDC states is 0.62 rems or 620 millirems a year. While the high-end figure of 543 millirems a year of gamma radiation on Nain Island is slightly lower than this average dose. While researchers describe the gamma radiation levels found in some parts of the Marshall Islands as much higher than those found around Chernobyl and Fukushima nuclear accidents, according to one source, this observation is only partially accurate. Some of the measurements taken in the Marshall Islands are indeed higher than some of the radiation levels measured at Fukushima. A 2019 Scientific American article about Fukushima states that radiation in some places continues to measure at least 5 millisieverts a year beyond natural background radiation, which is equivalent to 500 millirems a year. But some areas in Fukushima are still more radioactive than the Marshall Islands. Scientific American reports that in certain spots radioactivity is as high as 20 millisieverts or 2,000 millirems a year. This happens to be what one source describes as the yearly limit for occupational exposure set by the International Commission on Radiological Protection. Like Fukushima and the Marshall Islands, the radiation measurements taken around Chernobyl vary wildly. According to an infographic from a 2019 BBC News article, current radiation levels in the Chernobyl exclusion zone range from 0 to 12.07 plus microsieverts per hour. Some parts of Bikini and Nain Islands do have more radiation than some of the low radiation areas in the Chernobyl exclusion zone, such as those with a radiation level of 0.02 microsieverts an hour, or 17.52 millirems a year. However, even the highest radiation levels measured on Bikini and Nain Islands of 648 millirems a year and 543 millirems a year are no match for a hotspot in the Chernobyl exclusion zone, with a radiation level of 12.07 microsieverts an hour, which is 10,573 millirems a year. This amount of radiation is equivalent to the radiation you'd receive from around 1,057 chest x-rays. While this is a large amount of radiation, it would take much higher doses of radiation to cause serious negative biological effects. According to the CDC, 50 rems of radiation causes damage to blood cells, while 100 rems or 100,000 millirems is the lowest dose that could cause acute radiation syndrome. Being more radioactive than some parts of Fukushima and Chernobyl is not something positive to brag about. And there's more bad news. Columbia University researchers also measured the concentrations of several radioisotopes in soil samples taken in the Marshall Islands, including americium-241, plutonium-238, 239, and 240, and cesium-137. Despite the fact that more than 60 years has passed since nuclear testing ended, researchers found high concentrations of cesium-137, which is a major source of gamma radiation. Cesium-137 concentrations were highest in soil samples taken from Angibe, Runit, Bikini, and Nain Islands. The researchers observed that a few Nain samples, one Angibe sample, and one Runit sample were all above a Japanese food sanitation law limit for cesium-134 and cesium-137 in agricultural soils. They also state that these concentrations are also all above concentrations found in soil near the Chernobyl power plant less than 10 years after the accident. The Marshallese have already experienced firsthand some of the serious negative health effects of cesium-137. The EPA states that external exposure to large amounts of cesium-137 can cause burns, acute radiation sickness, and even death. A medical report by Jacob Robbins of the National Institutes of Health and William H. Adams of Brookhaven National Laboratory documents some of these symptoms in those living in close proximity to the Castle Bravo test in 1954. It states that on Rongelab, about two-thirds of people developed anorexia and nausea, and one-tenth had vomiting and diarrhea. In addition, it describes how skin burns appeared after 12 to 14 days in about 90% of the Rongelab inhabitants, with ulcerations in 15%. According to the EPA, internal exposure to cesium-137 produces another effect that the Marshallese are too familiar with. increased cancer risk. In 2010, the National Cancer Institute published a study about the cancer risk for Marshall Islands residents exposed to radioactive fallout from U.S. nuclear weapons tests. The authors of the study estimate that as much as 1.6% of all cancers, about 170 cancers among those alive, between 1948 and 1970 might be attributable to radiation exposures resulting from nuclear testing fallout. Their estimates for people living in Rongelap are much higher because they were exposed to higher levels of radiation. For the 82 people who lived on Rongelap Atoll, the authors projected 55% of all cancers might be attributed to fallout exposure. A Washington Post article sums up the cancer situation in the Marshall Islands by stating that everyone seems to have a relative whose cancer falls on the Energy Department's list of ailments traceable to radiation. Cesium-137 has a half-life of about 30 years, so people living in the Marshall Islands today are not being exposed to as much radiation as those who were alive during the time the tests were conducted. However, according to Live Science, the levels on Bikini and Nain Islands were so high they surpassed the maximum exposure limit that the United States and the Republic of the Marshall Islands agreed to in the 1990s. This limit is 100 millirems per year. This amount is less than the average dose people in the U.S. receive from naturally occurring background radiation, which the CDC states is 310 millirems per year. The results of this study may affect plans to repopulate these islands. The Columbia University researchers made some recommendations based on these results. One of them is that given the lifestyle of people living on remote atolls, it appears to us that cleanup of Nain and possibly other northern Rongelap Atoll islands would be needed before full atoll resettlement can be envisioned. Another recommendation is that the radiation levels on Bikini Island, which served as the primary island for habitation on the atoll, before and in the aftermath of the testing, are too high for relocation to Bikini. Newsweek reported that Bikini Island is still off-limits to residents because the radiation is still over the maximum limit. The average value of background gamma radiation levels on Bikini was found to be nearly double that limit. This means residents will not be able to return to Bikini. Residents have mixed reactions to the idea of returning to their island homes that are more radioactive than some parts of Fukushima and Chernobyl. Some Marshallese, such as 90-year-old Lirok Joash from Bikini Island, dream of going back even though it's not a realistic dream. In an interview with Al Jazeera America, she expressed her ideas in her native language, so her grandson Alson Kellen translated her words. "She's trying to say that she'd like to die and be buried on her homeland," Kellen explains, adding, "You and I know that's not possible." Others who have relocated to other islands or countries never want to return. The Guardian interviewed one of these exiles. "I won't move there," said Evelyn Ralpho Jadrick of her home atoll Rongelap, which was engulfed in fallout from Bravo and evacuated 2 days after the test. "I do not believe it's safe and I do not want to put my children at risk." And then there are others who focus not on the idea of returning, but on other significant damage caused by being forced to leave in the first place. One of them is Lanny Kramer, a councilwoman in Bikini's local government. In an interview with The Guardian, she said, "It's not just their homes that have been lost, but an entire swath of the island's culture." She adds, "As a result of being displaced, we've lost our cultural heritage, our traditional customs and skills, which for thousands of years were passed down from generation to generation. Would you visit the Marshall Islands, Fukushima, or Chernobyl? Or would the radiation keep you away? Let us know in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other video, Chernobyl Suicide Squad, 3 Men Who Prevented Even Worse Nuclear Disaster. Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.